Most people are aware through their research that chameleons need a heat bulb and a UVB bulb. But where there's a little bit of confusion is whether or not a chameleon needs a heat source at night. So I'm going to answer that for you guys today. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So do chameleons need a heat source at night? Should their heat lamp stay on? And the answer is no. Chameleons need total darkness in order to sleep, which means all lights should be off at night. That means their UVB bulb and their heat bulb. It even means any sort of overhead room lights. I think a TV light in the same room would be okay, but really want to give your chameleon complete darkness. And what people freak out about is like, oh my gosh, is my chameleon gonna get too cold? So let's talk about that a little bit. Chameleons actually benefit from a temperature drop at night. Chameleons thermoregulate, which means their body temperatures change with the environment that they live in, which means they can go up in the mornings to bask and warm up, but then at night, they actually benefit from the temperature being cooler. And so a lot of people are wondering, like, how cold is too cold for a chameleon? The ideal nighttime temperature ranges are going to vary between species, and it's going to be dependent on where in the world the chameleon comes from. So for a panther chameleon, we're aiming for 60 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit. For a veiled chameleon, 55 to 65 degrees Fahrenheit. For a Jackson's chameleon, 50 to 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, these are recommendations. These are general ranges. There's no need or reason to freak out if you're off by a couple degrees. This is just something that we're aiming for in the general ranges that we know have been successful with our chameleon care. Now, how cold is too cold? There have been lots of chameleons who have been kept outside in, say, Southern California, where it has gone into the 40s and even the 30s before, and they've been fine. This is not something that anyone would suggest for long term, but chameleons can handle a lot more than we give them credit for. So my suggestion and my recommendation is that you don't need to provide a heat source for a chameleon unless it gets below 50 degrees Fahrenheit in your home, in the room that the chameleon is in. What I find kind of interesting is some people will message me freaking out of like, oh, I live in somewhere super, super cold, or like, I live in Antarctica. Not really, but like, you get the point, right? They live somewhere very cold and they're like, oh, like my chameleon's gonna be freezing cold. I'm like, well, what's the temperature inside your home? They're like, 72 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm like, okay, it doesn't matter if it's 2 degrees outside. As long as the room that your chameleon is in is the correct temperatures, then it doesn't really matter if you live somewhere that's freezing cold. Now, if the room that your chameleon is in is consistently getting below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, then you may want to consider providing some heat sources that don't also put off light. So that's going to be things like a ceramic heat emitter, which you can put into the enclosure and that would provide some heat without putting off any light. Or the second recommendation would be some sort of portable heater that you could put into the room so the overall ambient temperature would increase. And then the third option, if you're really struggling to keep the temperatures where they need to be at night, would be to wrap the sides of your enclosure to kind of help hold in that heat. Maybe you look at getting a hybrid enclosure or a glass enclosure, or wrapping the sides of your screen enclosure to try and keep that heat in there. But really, like I said, that's not necessary unless the temperatures are getting really, really cold on a consistent basis. Now, one thing I did want to mention is the idea of red heat bulbs. So a lot of people will use a white heat bulb during the day and then switch to a red heat bulb at night. This is a common recommendation from reptile shops and pet stores, but it's not recommended for chameleons. Chameleons' eyes are very sensitive. It's how they communicate with each other. It's how they track their food. And it is not suggested to use red lights and during the daytime for sure, but definitely you don't need them at night. Because remember, chameleons need total darkness at nighttime. So I really encourage you, if you're using a red heat bulb during the daytime, to replace it with a bulb that puts off a white light. And if you're using it at night, just take it out. You probably don't need it. And if you do need some sort of heat source, we've already covered those. And just a pro tip, you can use an outlet timer, something you can plug into the wall and then plug your lights into, so then your lights will turn off and on automatically by themselves. This way you don't have to worry about if you're rushing off to school or work or you're getting home late, you know that your chameleon lights are taken care of. The general recommendation is for your chameleon lights to be on for 12 hours and off for 12 hours. So just pick a time that works for you, I would suggest anywhere from 7 to 9 a.m. and then somewhere to 7 to 9 p.m. are good suggestions. So there you have it. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Leave any questions or comments down below. Feel free to subscribe so you know when I post a new video. You can follow Neptune and all my chameleons on social media at Neptune Like Chameleon. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day. Bye. All right, now these are just... All right, 12th time's the charm.